So at the beginning of every visual is your own thoughts and your own preparation. What should it be? Yeah. So in my case, if I start a visual in the watercolor journal, I start with very fine marks. And let's say I would want to visualize a landscape or a seascape. Then I have to think up front, okay, so what is it composed of? Yeah, usually some water, maybe a sailboat, maybe some mountains, and so on. So I start thinking in terms of the structure. Yeah. So in terms of this page, I would say, okay, somewhere is the line of the water. Then we have some mountains maybe back there. Maybe somewhere here we have a sailboat. And maybe up here we have some clouds. Yeah? So what you see already is when we used to draw in school, we had an eraser. And we were erasing lots of stuff, and it was fun to do that. In business, we don't have the chance to erase. That's also why you didn't get an eraser, because it doesn't matter, you know, if those lines are crappy or not. People will recognize it. Yeah, I could have drawn the sailboat in 1,000 different ways, but everybody in the audience would expect a sailboat, you know, to have the body of the boat and the sail. That's enough. And that's also an important message for visualizing in business, that you have to reduce it to the most simple approach possible, yeah? And people will recognize it, that's good enough. Okay, but coming back to the watercolor sketchbook, we have a very nice tool here, and those are actually these water-filled brushes. And what you can do with them is, you can use a watercolor palette, like this here, with a lot of different colors, but still small. And I'm doing this just to show you how simple it is to remember something where you went to or what you did, yeah? So I'll have the palette here. And of course, let's say the water is blue. Actually, the water is never blue, but just for simplification reasons, let's assume our water is blue. So I can start filling in stuff here. Leave a little bit of space for my sailboat, which is called negative space if you leave out the space for the object. So everybody of you could do that because it's just, you know, you're just filling the space of the paper. Maybe not totally equally the color everywhere, but so that you have some reflections, so that's very easy, yeah? Okay, then I can maybe use a little bit more grayish for the sky up here. I don't need a lot. I just take a little bit of that. Then I go into the mountains, and the mountains will be a little bit more grayish in the background. Then a little bit more green, yellowish in the foreground. And yeah, then maybe I need a little bit for my sailboat down here just to have that. And then I can make the clouds a little bit darker here. But that's it, yeah? So what you see is it's a process, yeah? And exactly like we are learning mathematics or statistics, you can do the same in visuals. You have a starting point, you frame something out, and then you have steps. And of course, now it looks super easy. Of course, it's a little bit of experience, but it's not magic. It's not, you know, it's not a science. It's process steps that you can do, yeah? And exactly the same like for this watercolor page, also in business. You need to know, you know, where is my starting point? How far do I want to take it? How difficult do I want it to be? How nice do I want it to look? Where do I want to stop? And so that's nice to have this really as a process. Yeah, and we will see those different steps.